Excellency President Alma Jabek Atambayo, members of the media, it is great pleasure to visit this beautiful country. I am deeply touched by the warmth and the hospitality. Close ties over centuries creates a special kind of closeness and goodwill that adds a lot of charm and interest to the visit. Kyrgyzstan and India are also united by the bonds of shared democratic values. We see an important place for Central Asia in India's future. We can reinforce each other's economic progress. Sustainable development is important for both. We can contribute to cooperation and integration across the different regions of Asia. We both seek a peaceful and secure neighborhood at a time of challenges in our region. And we have shared interests in combating extremism and terrorism that has become a threat without borders. My visit to all five countries in the region demonstrates the importance that we attach to a new level of relations with Central Asia. Kyrgyzstan is a key part of that vision. I was pleased to meet President. His contribution to democracy and development is admirable. I am delighted that our election commissions have signed an agreement on cooperation. We also look forward to the visit of a Kyrgyz parliamentary delegation to India after the parliamentary election in Kyrgyz Republic. I had a very enriching discussion with President Atambayo. I deeply appreciate his commitment to the relationship. We spoke at length about strengthening our relations in trade, investment, tourism, culture, and human resource development. I welcome the agreements of standards and on culture today. Connectivity initiatives between India and Central Asia will boost our economic ties. I look forward to the launch of the telemedicine link with India. It is the first in the region, and it tells us about the possibilities of the digital world. We will also initiate the second phase of Kyrgyz-India Mountain Biomedical Research Center. We will enhance our engagement in capacity building and increase the training offers for Kyrgyzstan to 100 this year. I am pleased that we have established a India-Kyrgyz Center for Information Technology in the Kyrgyz State University in Bishkek. Information technology is critical for success today and for creating opportunities for the youth. We will be pleased to set up a similar centers in other major cities in Kyrgyzstan. Agriculture is an important sector in both India and the Kyrgyz Republic. We will shortly hold a roundtable Bishkek to explore possible avenue for cooperation and identify concrete projects in the agriculture sector. Later today, I will have the privilege of unveiling the statue of Mahatma Gandhi on the street that bears his name. I thank the people of Kyrgyzstan for this honor. His life and message are universal and timeless. This statue will also remind the residents of our shared values. Kyrgyzstan's commitment to the United Nations peacekeeping mission is truly laudable, and it is a great pleasure for India to support this effort on the strength of its long experience in this area. I will have the pleasure of handing over a small contribution of field medical equipment to Kyrgyz Armed Forces. Our defense ties are strong. We have just completed a joint exercise, Khanjar 2015. We have decided to hold joint military exercise on an annual basis. The IT center in the Kyrgyz Military Academy is an example of innovative cooperation that is important to both countries. Our new agreement on defense cooperation would provide a framework to broaden our engagement. This would include a defense technology. I congratulate President on Kyrgyzstan joining the Eurasian Economic Union. We agreed that a free trade agreement between India and EEU will substantially increase our cooperation. He expressed support for an early completion of the Joint Study Group feasibility report. We agreed that this would make Kyrgyzstan a base for India's economic engagement in the region. We also look forward to our engagement in the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. I am grateful for Kyrgyzstan's strong support to India's candidature for permanent membership for an expanded United Nations Security Council. I sought his support for early completion of the reforms of the United Nations and its Security Council. Finally, I thank President Atambayev and Kyrgyzstan for the support in making the International Day of Yoga on June 21st a huge global success. I look forward to my meeting with Speaker Jin Bekov and Prime Minister Sergeyev later today. I am confident that the visit will take our bilateral cooperation to new heights. I look forward to an early opportunity to receive President Atambayev in India. Thank you very much.